First of all, stop sabotaging yourself. Stop sabotaging yourself. If you want your race to be enjoyable, stop sabotaging yourself. He starts with these words. Let us throw off everything that hinders. Underline throw off. It's the word strip down. Ancient athletes, you know, in the Olympics, they actually stripped naked to compete, which I can imagine was quite liberating during the marathon, but when it came time to wrestle, I think I would probably balk at that thing. But that's beside the point. The fact of the matter is they had no clothes. They had nothing to encumber them, nothing to hinder them. They were free to run. I don't know if you've ever seen on the TV when they have a marathon, you know, maybe the White Rock Marathon. You've seen at the starting line these people dressed in these outlandish outfits, you know, like Mario and all these different huge costumes, and they are so weighted down by these costumes. Have you ever noticed anyone crossing the finish line in those costumes? Something happens between mile one and mile 26.3, whatever it is. Something happens probably about mile seven where there's a place where all those people go and they take the big stuffed banana off and they just finish the race. They strip down. Why? Because it's just harder. It's a hindrance to be covered with things that you don't need to be covered with. To be encumbered by things you don't need to be encumbered with. The word here, hinders, is a word that means literally a tumor or a mass or a weight, an impediment. It was used in the athletic arena of excess weight that an athlete needed to lose if they were going to run effectively. It could be symbolic of baggage that we carry or anxieties that we hold. Things like wealth or fame, certain hobbies, certain relationships. A Netflix habit. It can be a lot of different things. And it makes running the race harder. Now, this is a little tricky because none of these things are necessarily sinful. We're going to get to that in a second. But these things are simply hindrances. They're not necessarily sinful. So, it might be something that is a hindrance for you in your race, but for your brother or sister, it's not a hindrance for them at all. And one of the troubles that we get in is we look at someone else and we say, well, that person's not doing this, 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 and this, so that's what the Christian life is, so I'm not supposed to do this, 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 and this either. Or, conversely, we think, well, I'm not doing all these things so that I can run well. Why are you doing it? And we start to judge and be critical of one another. And it's a little tricky, isn't it? We saw in chapter 11 that Moses saw the wealth and the power of Egypt, something to strip himself of so he could run his race. Remember? We talked about that in chapter 11. Yet, Joseph ran his race in a power of supreme leadership in the very same Egypt. He did not see wealth and power and position as something he needed to strip off in order to run his race. They both ran it beautifully. So it might be something for you that you need to strip off that isn't necessarily something I need to strip off. There is no hard and fast rule.